In 2016, there were over 2,000 constituency projects nominated by members of the National Assembly. Some of the projects were completed, some were abandoned, and some were never started at all. There's also the case of projects appearing repeatedly per budget cycle. Just for illustration, say a healthcare center appears in the budget for a community in 2015. Then you notice that same healthcare center appears in the 2016 budget as well. As a country, do we have a solid budget implementation report? Do we know which constituency projects are budgeted for and executed yearly? Is there a document that can tell you how much was appropriated for a project, how much was released for that project, when it was released, to whom was it paid, the scope of the project paid for? These and many more questions need to be asked and answered if we are truly to bring about accountability and transparency in the expenditure of public funds. Dame Mokede is a member of the budget team. He oversees the investigative team across 20 states of the country who partner with Channels Television and help in tracking public projects in Nigeria. Listen to our conversation on the implementation report of the 2016 budget for constituency projects.
In 2016, $100 billion was budgeted for constituency projects. So we started tracking 2016 constituency projects from the month of June. So far, we've been able to track 852 projects. We have a total number of 350 projects that have been completed. We have a total number of 118 projects ongoing. We have 41 projects non-specified and 343 projects not done. Actually, the normal timeline for tracking projects is supposed to be from May to May, but just due to the delay in the budget, they released constituency project in June 2016. So the timeline for tracking project is when the new constituency project is out. So you have to stop the old ones that you've been tracking. So for 2016, there was a delay in releasing constituency project. It came out very late. But if you look at the lifespan for constituency project, it's supposed to be May 31st. So we started June. The limitations we encountered during the comparison of it, because we have a very large numbers of projects that are not executed. But we have almost about 343 projects that were not executed. We also faced with challenges of project location. We could not locate some particular project, and most of the projects that we were able to track, the residents are not even aware of the project. So when you go to local communities to ask them about project, they tell you that they are not aware of it. So these are the challenges that we faced. The community people, they are not even ready to give us information because they are not aware of most of those projects that we were tracking. The prevailing trend in 20 constituency projects was the one unspecified location of project. There is no real detail of how of project that has been captured in the budget. So the specification, they will just tell you construction of 20 hand pump borehole in XYZ Central District. So a Central District is a very big place where the locations are not being specified. So we find it very difficult to track this project. Also, project specification is also an issue whereby they tell you construction of block of three classrooms. On getting to the project location, you discover that it's just a block of two classrooms that has been implemented. Also, we also have another big problem with empowerment items, materials. On empowerment materials, we find it very difficult to track the beneficiaries. You don't know them. So in the situation where they said they are making provision procurement for 100 pieces, when you get to some communities, you only see one beneficiary. So how are we sure that actually 100 pieces were being supplied? So these are the challenges we are facing in the cost of our tracking. And also we have cases of where a particular project has been captured both in the state and the federal. We have a case like that in those states, Otuo, where there's a provision for the procurement and completion of a health center. And this same project was captured in the Edo state budget for 57 million, while in the federal constituency project was captured for 200 million. The major highlight we observed in the tracking process was we have tax-funded, government tax-funded projects are now labeled as donation. So I think this does not really tell rules of our representative because they use constituency project as their own personal donation. So we have cases of where hospital ambulance were being supplied the tax is as donated by the senator representing that constituency. We also have empowerment materials supplied to citizens, and they all tagged as donations. So these are some of the challenges. Also, we also have the conversion of constituency project to personal property. There's a particular project in Kebbi State where there's a provision for 71 borehole across the 71 ward. Initially, we even have a problem with that because the 71 ward were not specified. So we were able to sensitize the people of that constituency to tell them to engage their representatives in view of this project. So we realized that in June, we got a call from the community that there's a borehole project in their community, that the community are now complaining that the borehole project is being installed the borehole project inside the house of a serving senator. And the signpost for that project was outside. So our tracking officers went there to see things for himself. So we declared that borehole was part of the 71 borehole that was supposed to be constructed in that constituency. And this borehole had converted to a personal property, that depriving the residents access to get water from the senator's compound. Because the compound is being fenced. So now they need water. So they need to always knock before they get water. So if this borehole is being constructed in a public place, I think the citizen will have access to get water from the community. But now they need to knock on the senator's gate before they could get access to the water, to the premises to get water. One of the recommendations for this 2017, I think one, there should be more, project specifications should be more details. Locations of projects should be known, should be stated clearly so that citizens can have access to track those projects. Also, representatives should always seek the attentions of their constituency. They should carry people at the grassroots along. They should ask them what are those pressing needs they need in their community so that they too can also contribute. Maybe in a situation whereby the community they need water, then you are giving them solar power street light, which is of no importance to them, which will not even last up to 1 month. So I think these are the, and there should be open contract system where people can have idea about how much this contract is being awarded so that people can follow up and track the progress of that work. So far, we've been able to mine the 2017 budget, and we still find out that the same problem we are facing in 2016 is still appearing in 2017, because if you look at most of the projects in 2017 budget are empowerment. And this empowerment, they are not well detailed to who benefits this. So you look at most, let me say 50% of the projects in 2017 are empowerment projects, procurement of empowerment materials to people at different central districts.
So about half of the 2017 budget for constituency projects is for empowerment. And according to Mr. Dame, these ones are very difficult to track for accountability, as beneficiaries are scattered all over. But wait a minute. Haven't legislators often argued that constituency projects are aimed at bridging the infrastructure gap in rural communities? Infrastructure, empowerment. Oh well, let's take a break. We'll be right back after this. Please stay with us.